Hey you guys, I'm back. So today I'm gonna be doing some book reviews for you guys because I'm due for more book reviews and I haven't done some in a while. I feel really, really bad because these books I'm gonna review today, I read them a couple weeks ago, and so don't mind me if these reviews are so random and not well put together because, like I said, I finished these books weeks ago, so I'm sorry, I don't remember too much about them, but I really, really wanted to do reviews for these. It's just, I honestly haven't been feeling like making videos lately. I'm so sorry. But yeah, but first, really quickly, before I get started with the reviews, I just wanted to give you guys a little update on what I'm currently reading. So if you guys saw my last video, I started the book club, The Reading Fangirls, on Goodreads, and our read-alongs this month are for Cinder and The Giver. But like I said before, I'm not reading The Giver because I don't have the book. My library doesn't have it. I can't afford to buy any more books right now, so I'm sorry. But I wanted to do Cinder too, so I'm currently reading Cinder. And I like it so far. I'm like 180 pages in. At first, I didn't really like it. I couldn't get into it. But it's getting a lot better now. So that was just a quick update. Anyway, let's get on to the reviews. So today I'm going to be giving you guys two reviews. So first, I'm going to be reviewing Lullaby by Amanda Hocken. This is book 2 in the Water Song series by Amanda Hocken, and this is the first book, Wake. Now, I do not have a review for this on my channel because I read this book like last October. I think it was last October, and I didn't have my channel then, but I have a review for this on my blog. If you guys want to check it out, I will link my blog down below. Anyway, I'm just going to get started with this video, and then after I review Lullaby, I'm going to be reviewing Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, because yes, I finally read this book. You guys are going to kill me, but I have never read Harry Potter. And by the way, these reviews are going to be no spoilers. I'm trying not to spoil my books, because I feel if my book reviews don't have spoilers on them, more of you will watch them, because there's no spoilers. Anyway, let's get started. So I'm reviewing Lullaby by Amanda Hocken. So like I said before, this is book 2 in the Water Song series. The first one is Wake. I already showed you Wake. Basically, I'll try my very best to describe this series. Basically, and I'm really bad at describing books, by the way, so don't mind me. Basically, this series is about a girl named Gemma. She's 16. She has a sister named Harper, who's 18, 2 years older. And basically, there's been these murders in their town lately, and there's this group of girls who are very mysterious, and no one knows who they are. And this is not a spoiler because it's actually on the inside flap for the book. So basically, those mysterious girls are sirens, you know, Greek mythology. So they're basically sort of mermaids. So it's kind of like, you know, when they sing, they like enchant boys and stuff, and like get their attention, you know, they make boys love them, basically. And so, the main character, Gemma, this is not a spoiler, it's in the description for the book. So I was kind of mad about that because, it said it in the flap of Wake that Gemma turned into a siren, and I was kind of mad about that because I didn't want to be spoiled, but I read the flap. But anyway, yes, Gemma turned into a siren, and so basically, in the end of the book, I'm sorry guys, I have to spoil it a little bit too. I have to spoil this a little bit just to describe the second book. Basically, Gemma ends up going with the girls, the mysterious girls, because they sort of make her. But I'm not going to spoil anything else. And so, this book takes place with Gemma being with the other girls. And Gemma doesn't want to be a siren at all. She really doesn't. She wishes she was back with her friends, and she has a boyfriend in this book. But she wishes she was back with her sister and her boyfriend. And like I said, the sirens sort of forced her to go with them, and she doesn't want to be with them at all. And so her sister, Harper, is trying to find Gemma, because she doesn't know where they went at all. And so she asks Gemma's boyfriend, Alex, which is also Harper's best friend, to help her find Gemma. And she also needs, in the first book, she meets this guy named Daniel, and he's a really good guy. And so joins Harper and Alex on the search for Gemma. I'm not going to spoil anything else for you guys, but I love this series so much. I gave Wake 5 out of 5 lily pads, and I gave this 5 out of 5 lily pads. You guys should really check out this series if you love books that... It's sort of like mermaids, sirens. If you guys love those kind of books, like books that take place in the water like I do, you will love this series. It's so good. I love Amanda Hawkins' writing style. Her writing style is so, so simple, which I love about it. I love that about her writing style. And these books are so easy to get through. I easily flew through these books. I love her characters. The main character, Gemma, she's really likable. I like her so much. I love it because her and her older sister, Harper, they have such a strong sisterly bond with each other. And I can really relate to that because I have two other sisters myself. So I can really, really relate to it. And I love Harper so much. She's that typical overprotective big sister. And like I said, I love that because I have a younger sister. So yes, I can really relate to that. And the characters are amazing in this series. I love Alex. I love Daniel. He's such a good guy. I can't describe too much about these characters because I told you I don't want to spoil anything, but yeah. You guys should really, really check out this series if you guys love books take place in the water. And yes, I love the covers. How could I forget? But this cover is much better. There's two more books in this series. The next one's called Title. I don't own it yet, but I really want to read it. I know my library has it, so maybe I'll borrow from the library. So you guys should really check out this series because, like I said before, it's just so, so good. And it's sort of underrated in BookTube. So you guys, I'm not forcing you guys to check out these books because you guys can read whatever you want to read. Remember that. Don't read a book that's popular in BookTube just because it's popular. Read whatever you guys want to read, because that's what I do. I read like 90% underrated books and contemporary. So I read whatever I want to read, and you guys should too. So anyway, that was my short review for Lullaby. So next I'm going to move on to Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. What can I say about this book? Okay, I have to admit, I really, really enjoyed this book. I give it 5 out of 5 lily pads too. Okay. I'll give you a quick backstory. You know, I already said it. So like I said before, I always heard of Harry Potter. Always. I always knew it was popular. I've seen two of the movies when I was younger. And I told you, I never wanted to read Harry Potter. I knew how popular it was, but I never wanted to read it for some reason. I honestly was never interested in it. I'm like, what's so good about wizards and stuff like that? I was never interested. But like I said before, Everyone on BookTube loves this series, and there's so many references to Harry Potter, so you know what? I thought I would give this series a try, and I am so glad I did because this book was really, really good. I loved it so much. I don't know if I should say spoilers. Should I say spoilers? Because I'm sure most of you have read it, but if there's one of you out there that hasn't read this yet, then I won't spoil it. But I think you guys already know what Harry Potter is about, so I don't really want to just go into too much detail describing it. So I'll just tell you what I liked about it. First of all, the characters. I loved Harry. He was so normal. By normal, I mean like, what's the word? Just an average guy. Because in this book, he's 11. So he turned 11. And honestly, I never knew that he had such a bad life. I mean, before I read these books, I always thought Harry Potter was always like, I thought he always had such a great life because he's so famous. But I had no idea that he had such a bad life, you know, when he was living with his aunt and uncle and Dudley, did you pronounce his name? I never knew he had it so rough. And I just love him so much because in this book, he's not really confident yet. He doesn't really know who he is. And when they tell when Hagrid tells him he's a wizard and he's famous and his parents are famous, I felt so happy for him. And like, I loved how Harry wasn't confident in himself yet because he's so normal. He was like, I can't be a wizard. I just can't because it's not me. And And I loved how he didn't know anything about wizards or magic. And when he had the opportunity to go to Hogwarts, I felt so happy for him because he really deserves it. He was such a normal kid. I mean, he was, like, bullied by his aunt and uncle and his cousin and his cousin's friends. I felt so bad for him. Like I said, I never knew he had it rough. I never did. And I can really relate to Harry in some ways. So I really, really liked Harry. Like I said before, I love how when he goes to Hogwarts, he doesn't let the cool kids like him, suck up to him. Like Draco Malfoy. Draco Malfoy, like, I love how he like stood up to Draco and he chose being friends with Ron, who's a Weasley and a loser to Draco. I love how he chose Ron over Draco, because, you know, Draco's, like, the cool one, the mean one. But I love how he chose Ron, and Ron's such a normal guy. He's awesome. I love Ron, too. Ron is such a cute, he was such a good guy. He's so cute. And, yeah, I just love how in this book, the main characters, they're just so normal and relatable. That's what I loved. Like I told you, like, in the book, when they're in, like, their wizard, when they're in their classes, like, the potions class, like, Harry didn't know anything. He didn't know anything. He's supposed to be the amazing Harry Potter, but he didn't know anything about magic. And when Snape, like, asked him stuff, he didn't know anything. Like, and I actually, you guys would probably hate this, because a lot of BookTubers love reading books with very strong main characters. And I actually loved how in this book, like I said before, I loved how in this book, Harry wasn't confident in himself at all. He wasn't. I loved that about him because I know he will develop in this series. In this series, I know he will become more confident. I just know he will. And like I said, I love that because it's so relatable because, honestly, I'm not a confident person at all. So I can just relate to Harry so much. He's just so likable. And like I said before, I had no idea he had it so rough before he went to Hogwarts. So he really deserved it. He really deserved the opportunity. He's just so good. Other characters, I loved, like I said, I loved Ron. I loved Hermione. Hermione, she's so intelligent and kind. And I just love her. And I'm so glad that she's friends with Harry and Ron now. Because at first, they didn't like her. And yeah, I really, really liked Hermione. She was awesome, too. I love Dumbledore. Snape. At first, I didn't know what to think of Snape because, I don't know, he seemed sort of mean. But I'm not going to spoil anything. You know, you guys have probably all read this before me. Because I'm the last person on the face of the earth who hasn't even read Harry Potter yet, so. And, I liked Hagrid. He was really, really nice. That was so nice of him to stand up for Harry and to take Harry shopping. For everything at Hogwarts, and yes, I would love to go to Hogwarts. I really would. It's so awesome. Who doesn't want to go to that boarding school? I mean, come on. It's just so, so cool. Oh, and by the way, I made an account on Pottermore.com. I'm sure you guys know what that website is. It's basically a website that the author made up. It's so cool. You can, like, play games and you live in one of the houses. So I took a quiz to find out and see which house I would be in. And I got Hufflepuff, which is so cool. I think Hufflepuff is, like, the, Is Hufflepuff, like, the humble one? The one, the people who don't brag and think they're cool. They're, like, the humble one. So that describes me a lot. So, yeah. So, like I said before, I really, really enjoyed this book. I'm so glad I gave it a try. I am definitely going to be reading the other books in this series because, for my birthday, I asked my mom to buy me the Harry Potter box set on Amazon, and she did. So, I will definitely be continuing the rest of the series. So that's it for my reviews. If you guys have read any of these books, please comment below, tell me what did you think. And, yeah, that's it for my review. Sorry, it's so long. But thank you so much for watching. I love you guys. Bye.